just like, it sounds like trying to like unnecessarily make a word cutesy. When like bits are
Is it
recording?
Yeah. Alright, so we got the Young Dragoon versus Swing Man.
He's coming from someone who's been trying to beat him with our character. I'd say he doesn't do well. I'd say he could do better, but lately he's been closer.
I've only played Dragoon a couple times. I was at Smash House the other day and I was super drunk. And he was like handing me. He was like handing me. Pretty handily.
He was like, what? Here you go.
Yeah. And I was like, alright, so first of all, when did you get that? And like, dude, I mean, clearly you can't blame it on the alcohol. He's working toy gun right now.
Yeah, he is. I like that stall. That stall's very
Yeah, that was crucial.
Yes. So I think one of the most important things about that stall in this matchup for Mario and Pikachu is that Swing Man and Lucina in general like to commit with things like, yeah, I'm gonna have Smash, I'll Smash with him. They think about their plan.
And then that's Mario goes in.
Oh, I am. But yeah, he, like, has like pretty lag half. And that stall puts him just around between Mario and Lucina.
You know,
it
just occurred to me. You know how we're both same kind of fun. Why don't we go back to go watch like one of the later and you can't hear anything we're saying? And then we're just having a conversation over the screen.
Yeah, now I'm worried. Hey, Dustin, Jack, can you hear us? Did you hear me? Name something that rhymes with orange.
Hey, if you can hear me decently, press F. If you can't hear me, you aren't gonna type anything because you can't fucking hear me.
Yeah. I think mine's a bit upbeat. I'm surprised it didn't work up there. He would have got, I mean, I guess he wouldn't have gotten punished that hard about it. Just like, okay, up tilt or something. But, like, I feel like the way that Lucina wins is not from, like, putting it in neutral and then, like, getting a massive combo off it. It's more just, like, repeatedly beating it.
Yeah.
Just
over, like Diddy Kong stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so, it's off stage and also just keep people in disadvantage. I think that's what they reckon. Swingman's doing some stuff right now that I really like. I see what he's trying to bait out. And your name isn't how you spell Ness.
It's a soft Ness.
Just use a Z. Alright, so we're getting down to the wire. Last dot, last hit situation.
Yeah, this is looking not too good. Good, I'll smash, by the way.
Yeah, it's not gonna do that.
That 5%.
This is definitely not what's going to be a disadvantage against Mario.
Yeah, that flood was pretty risky. They're both just doing really risky things right now.
Okay, actually, I see.
Smash gonna do it.
Okay, so, I've been
taking game one.
So trying to condition him into like running in and shielding and thinking it's a safe option so that he can get the shield. Like,
yeah.
He almost got it, but he jumped. If he didn't jump,
Mario jumped.
Spoinkman jumped. He like short hop and turned around and held him. But he would have landed in if he didn't jump. Yeah.
It's very it's definitely really close, and it's hard to pinpoint what exactly is like. One of the most important things Mario has to do against Mario and Lucina to win this matchup is just win neutral once, and then just continuously juggle because Mario doesn't have a little trouble landing. But Mario and Lucina are going to win, which has just been like, kind of beating him the way that Mario normally beats Mario. Just getting sick of this.
Just spacing him out, yeah.
Yeah,
like, he hasn't been getting into like crazy strings or anything like that.
Right, exactly.
Like,
which, I mean, it's working in this matchup is really good. And getting out of those situations. Ooh, good. Mark would go well, I think.
Hey, I actually don't know how to change the score. It's 1-0 Dragoon. I literally don't know how to change the score. Oh! No! No! Oh, shit! He ran off stage. He flew through. Whoa! Jesus Christ! Yo, someone get this man's out of here! Is Floyo back? Alright, so. Oh, no, no, no. He, I think he was PR in Houston or something like that. I believe so. Oh. I don't know. We'll ask him after. We'll ask him after the match. Oh, he went for the Tiger Boy option. I respect it. Yeah, for sure. Especially because of how much, like, stage control.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's always about just going for it.
Yeah.
Oh! Yeah, okay, so, I feel like...
That was...
I was just watching a set where Charlie the King lost his interview with that exact setup. And I thought, no, it was Dan versus Haven Man.
Yeah.
He killed Rob at like 80 at the top of like a highlight or something like that. And all I could think to myself was, I didn't know that could kill. And here, Dragoon is reminding
again.
Me again.
Yeah.
And now I gotta play another damn Mario Ditto, but I am happy that Swankman, I don't have to play Swankman.
Yeah. Alright.
Alright, well, hopefully he cools off because I hate.
Yeah, that was. So,
that was zero.
So, okay.
I mean, okay, here's the thing though. That down air. It wasn't a bad option.
It was good.
It's like the down.
I think that was
no,
optimal.
I mean, like from Spoinkman. Spoinkman's down air like went through his hat.
Wait. Oh, he did that out of a throw. He did down throw.
Yeah, no, he did. He did. Okay, so he did down throw and then he did double jump down air. And Spoinkman came down from disadvantage with down air. And instead of Spoinkman's huge disjoint beating out Mario's hands, Mario was just like.
And Mario's down air is a weird move that has a lot of like.
Yeah.
I don't think Swankman was expecting a down air. I think he had expecting up B, maybe. Actually, I don't know if it would have been up B. He was probably expecting up B or something. Either way, he said he's coming for me, let me down. One last thing I will say on that matchup, though, is I think that. I don't think Swankman was playing that optimally, obviously, but
right.
I think a large part of it was the fact that he's been so used to playing my Mario.
Yeah.
That looked nothing like my Mario.
No, dude. Dragoon is a Mario.
I'm not gonna say that.
Okay, so Nestek, what you are is you're someone who has a good neutral and you like Mario. Dragoon is a Mario.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Dragoon is smarter too. I think his Mario is much smarter than him. I think when I play Swankman, I just get like bad, like
I think you just do Mario stuff.
Yeah.
You know?
I go for it more. Okay, so another thing is Dragoon didn't really go for very many like grab combos because I don't think of course Swankman's good at getting out of those.
Yeah.
I don't know if he just like naturally doesn't go for those very often, or if he said, I'm not trying that shit on one more scene.
On no more scene, yeah.
Yeah, because they worked it. Because I think a lot of trades that I lose against Swankman is I'm trying to do
And then you trade an up B for an up air, and that's not a good trade for you.
Or like up air. Spot but Dragoon just playing a very clean, safe control, and also just came with a lot of unpredictable things that I don't do for this
game. Yeah.
Like, you went off stage for like more deeper, more resolute exactly. Plus, I'll talk about that in
Alright, so choose Zephyr. I believe this was the first incarnation of King Kong before they cut it. For my trivia fans. Okay, I'm not positive about how this matchup goes, but I can't imagine it's great for Donkey Kong. Alright, so it's 6-4 in Donkey Kong's favor from what I hear. Definitely one of Sonic's tougher matchups, but Chew is definitely not making it look that way. Because Zephyr is just running a clinic. Definitely looking like he's never played Sonic before.
Yeah, as much as often as you see the other team tournaments, I don't know if I should play Donkey Kong.
I don't mean it, actually.
Okay, so.
Okay. He stayed. He did spot dodge twice. I don't know.
I think
he, like,
twice.
He, like, shielded it, rolled into him, and then spot. I don't know. But he did three actions.
That's amazing.
Let's take it to the crowd. What do you guys think? Twitch chat, press F if he, it's probably speak for yourself.
Okay, I miss your dumb. It's not
I like money.
I like money too.
I like money. Hey!
Yeah, so a couple more hits. I think you might be out of range.
like Zephyr's no like being on stage. Like he's gonna like mix up his recovery time. He doesn't just go as soon as you can go. He doesn't buffer and get up off. That was nice. Zephyr's approach to the matchup, I think, was super optimal. Like, he sort of foreboded easy bread and butter combos for the sake of just, like, getting him off stage and keeping him there and racking up a bunch of free percent and pressure.
Yeah, he didn't do that much, like, easy stuff.
Yeah.
That was just survival!
Because he can't grab you if he's off stage.
I think it was, like, a little bit of whiffing by you as well. 3, 2, 1,
go! The mix up.
Yeah, so it's just one of the things. Which is hard.
Hey, you know what? Honestly, now that I look at it and think about it, you're completely right. Choose me as your macro, and Charles is just waiting for that stuff.
Yeah, that first 10 seconds.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, you just got it back in the back of the shield.
Which is also known as the how to beat four glory players strategy. Wait for them to press buttons and then you grab them. Yeah. Which is, yeah, that's like one of Donkey Kong's best. Choose smoke and the ganja to deal with the pressures of TO, and I don't blame him. But it's definitely hurting his reaction time here.
So that kill definitely got a little bit of a I think so.
He just pulled the trigger, yeah. Zephyr's actually playing so clean right now. No, he is. Yeah. Zephyr's an aggressive soccer too. Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, okay. So you're going back trying to demonstrate for the
saves. Yeah, I don't know. I thought he was about to bait him.
Nope, coming out from Tuesday.
Alright. Okay, alright.
He wanted the regrab!
I was about to say, Chu remembering what character he's playing. Because if you look at these neutral interactions, Chu's actually just like pressing A. And Donkey Kong isn't traditionally a character that tries to win matchups by pressing A.
Okay, so I think one more Chu.
It's like, we don't press A, huh?
So one thing I will give to Prosser right now is this man's not playing with headphones on. He's playing really well for someone who can hear all this cheering.
Yeah. But like, you also have to understand that as a hard working member of American society, he's been trained from birth. I'm saying because he's they're trained to be able to play violin while in the Tiger Tank.
Trying
to keep the tigers and the sharks. Hey, nah, I got in for throwing a trash can. this is pretty good for Zephyr. I know Sonic likes to stay, and Zephyr definitely likes to stay. I see what she's going for, you cheeky SOB.
Yeah, he really likes that. I said it. He's blown up. So Zephyr's going for some decent, or not very smart, but he's just a bunch of.
he's just slightly misspacing all these grabs. Like, he'll get pushed back, like, he'll get shield poke and then push back some, and then he'll whiff the grab. Oh, on Battlefield? Okay.
Yeah, I was surprised that girl went down the battlefield. That's so important here, though. Just
hey, where's Serac? Both characters punching at the same time, both missing. So it was on one hand, I think it's that, and on the other hand, like, Seth likes. He used to just, like, kind of spam the cartoon punch and use it to, like, call out the boss. But lately, what he's been doing, which I love, is he's been waiting until it might kill him.
Oh, so he doesn't do it like 30%.
Yeah, like he'll catch the thing that he wants the cartoon punch, and then he'll wait for you to get to hypersensitive.
Right. Which is, that's good.
Yeah.
It makes you stop thinking.
You completely forget it's an option. No.
Oh, and that's gonna do it, and Shu gets a very good win on this effort. Despite how bad that first game looked, playing under pressure, like,
winner is.
That's impressive.
Donkey Kong.
And Chu rigs the bracket. To secure another win.